on Camas, Alicia King. And remember, I was talking to you about community. And how do we get to know people in our community better? We ask questions. So I'm here today to chat a little bit with some of your awesome teachers. Who knows Mrs. Hanson? Everybody give a cheer. Woo! Woo! Okay, settle down, settle down. So I know you probably think you know everything about this amazing second grade teacher, but I bet you don't know everything. So, Mrs. Hanson, do you play any instruments?
Oh, I play a lot of instruments.
A
I bet
lot.
You don't know that.
A lot. Okay, tell us all the instruments you play.
Let's see. I play the piano. Mm-hmm. Somewhat good.
Okay.
I play the clarinet.
The clarinet.
And the saxophone.
The saxophone.
And I play the flute just a little bit, but that's what I really wanted to play when I was little was the flute.
Uh-huh.
And I play the drums.
The drums.
I actually took lessons. I'm playing the whole shebang.
Wow. So basically, you could have your own band.
I could.
She could have her own band, you guys. Did you have to practice all the time?
I did have to practice all the time. I took piano lessons for 10 years, and
wow.
I had a piano teacher, and I had to do a lot of practicing. Forever.
Well, we love hearing about all these instruments, and maybe next time you're in music class, Miss Wilson could get Miss Hanson to come in and play something for you guys.
Ooh,
I think
that'd
she'd be
blast.
Awesome. All right, let's give one big cheer for Mrs. Hanson. Woo! Yay! All right, on to the next teacher.
Hey there, kids. I think you know who this teacher is. This is Miss Bell, your kindergarten teacher here. Can we all cheer for Miss Bell? Yay! Woo!
Okay, simmer down, simmer down. Miss Bell, I heard that you love animals. Is this true?
Oh, I love animals. I'm a big animal lover. A lot of you know I'm a big fan of goats.
Goats.
Yes.
I love that. They eat the weeds, right?
Oh, they eat everything.
I need a goat. Yes. Okay, have you ever rescued an animal, or tell us a story that has to do with animals, Miss Bell?
I have. Once I was driving down a really busy street, and I saw llamas. Big, hairy llamas.
In the middle of the street?
Coming out into the middle of the street.
Okay.
And I was afraid for them, but I've never been in front of a llama before. So I had to pull over. Llamas are a little scattery.
Uh-huh.
They got a little nervous,
uh-huh.
But I just thought, pretend that they're goats. And so I went up to the llamas, and I tried shooing them back in, and they got scared of me, and they ran back into their yard, and I got to call the animal, the people who are in charge of the animals, and then let them know that we just saved some llamas. And that
Were they running wild?
They were.
Okay.
Yes, they
so
were.
Not only is she a kindergarten teacher, she is a llama saver.
Yes.
Right. I think that's amazing. So you see, there are stories about your teachers you don't even know about. She rescued llamas one day. Mm-hmm. Kids, let's give a cheer for Miss Bell. Yay! All right, on to the next teacher. All right, kids, I think you know who this guy is, but I'm not sure. This is your principal, Mr. McMillan. Hey.
How you doing?
Good. Let's
Good.
Give a cheer for Mr. McMillan. Yay! Woohoo! Okay, simmer down, simmer down. So I know you think you know this guy. He's walking around the school. He makes sure everything is on track here. But there might be something you don't know. And actually, I think this is pretty cool. So tell me, I think you have some friends you had a long time ago. And are they still your friends?
Absolutely. I've had some friends that I've developed in elementary school, just like here at Grass Valley. My elementary school was called Francis Willard. It was in Illinois.
Francis Willard.
We were the Francis Willard Roadrunners.
Roadrunners,
kind of like
fast?
The cartoon. I was one of the fastest kids in the school, at least I thought I was.
Uh-huh.
I have some friends that I had when I was, I went there from kindergarten to sixth grade,
mm-hmm.
and I've had some lifelong friends there that I then went to junior high with and then high school with,
wow.
and developed some other close friends along the way, and we're still close today, to the point where my friends, when they're back in town in
uh-huh.
Illinois, they'll go visit my family because they know them.
Wow.
And and we've met, we meet once a year, we made a commitment to each other, and we try to meet once a year somewhere across the United States just to get together and have fun.
Great.
And as a matter of fact, this summer,
uh-huh.
We're meeting in San Diego in the Del Mar area to go
fun.
Play on the beach and spend 3 days
fun.
Together just to reconnect. And the funny thing about this group of friends of mine
uh-huh.
is that sometimes we don't talk to each other for a while, and then we'll text each other or call each other
mm-hmm.
on the phone, or some of them do social media, but when we see each other, it's literally like we were just in school yesterday.
Aww.
And revert back to just being silly little boys.
You're back to being a roadrunner.
Yeah, and it's absolutely a blast.
Great.
I love those guys, and I just feel really blessed that I've been able to have such good friends and be able to grow that our entire lives.
Great. Yeah. Well, I think that's a pretty cool message, you guys, because I think you're making some friendships here at Grass Valley Elementary, and you just might be getting together with them down the road to go to San Diego or travel together, and someday you might have kids and get your friends together and hang out. So I think that's pretty cool. Do you want to give a shout out? Can you give us the names really quick, a little shout out?
Oh, absolutely. Floyd, Brian, Mike, Rick, Eric, Joe. Come
nice.
To see you guys soon.
Nice. All right, everybody, it's your principal, Mr. McMillan. Let's give one last cheer. Woo! Yay! All right, thank you.
Hey, kids, I bet you know where I am. I'm in your school garden out here, the Grass Valley School Garden, and it's just beautiful. And I'm here with Mrs. Della Valley. Do you guys know this lady? Let's give a shout out. Yay! Yay! Okay, sit down.
All right, so some exciting news is I know that we've been talking with some other teachers about what you might not know about them, mm-hmm. but we're going to talk a little bit with Mrs. Della Valley about something you do know, and then we're going to tie into a story you need to hear. So I know you know Mrs. Della Valley loves the environment. She loves recycling. She loves plants. I think she even loves weeds and worms. So we're going to chat with her a little bit today about something that the whole community ties into this. And I want you to share with us this story that you have about how things come together here in the garden.
Thanks, Mrs. King. I'm really glad to be able to share this story. As some of you know, we have on Earth Day, we had two centers. One was a seed planting center. One also was a worm bin center. But you might not know the story behind the seed planting center. Since we're talking about community today, I wanted you to know that community can extend further than just your neighborhood where you live, or the city where you live, or the state. Actually, this little story about how we got the seeds for Earth Day goes all the way to the Midwest in a state called Iowa. We received a grant about $100 to $200 worth of heirloom garden seeds. This is just one of the kinds of seeds. They were mostly vegetables, some flowers, and they're not usually the kind of seeds that you can buy. They're seeds that were passed down from one generation to another and saved. And so they are very precious, and we're trying to get them to propagate and maybe have, if you planted one of these on Earth Day, pass some of the seeds when the plant cycles over to someone else. What I did want to mention, though, is that these seeds went full cycle in another way. We were able to give back to our community using these seeds in March when the eco officers made newspaper pots getting ready for Earth Day, but also reusing recycling newspaper to make some pots for something called First Friday. In downtown Camas, we were invited to come with the high school and be a part of something called a Kids Zone. And we went down, Mrs. Schroeder and I went down to downtown Camas, where they had in the Journey Church, they had nonprofits. The Camas High School set up a recycling table with junk, and they sent some kids over to help us with the newspaper pots and seeds. And people came with their toddlers, with school kids, with grandkids, and they planted some of our seeds that we were using in Earth Day that we received from this grant, and they started their gardens in these newspaper pots. So that was when we at Grass Valley gave back to the community. One thing that I wanted to point out about all this is that when I tell my students that they, if they help others, they are friends with others, that lots of times this comes full circle. And when you need help, they'll be willing to help you, to be your friend, to help you out in one way or another. And that's what I think community is all about.
I don't think I could have said that better, you guys. I hope you understand what an amazing teacher you have here, and definitely an inspiration for the world around us. and the community and the people, because you're right, when it comes down to it, that's really what's important. So
thank you, Mrs. King.
You're welcome. Thanks. I want to see you kids out there being friendly to each other, helping each other. And it's not just here at your school, it's out in your community. Get to know your neighbors, get to know some people that you can help. You can help weed a yard, whatever is a family project you can do out there to make our community stronger. I really appreciate your story today.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you for sharing. All right, this is Alicia King, Just a Girl in Camas. Thank you.
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. All through my city, all through my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket. Got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it. Moving so phenomenally. You're more like the way we rock it. So don't stop. Under the lights when everything goes. Nowhere to hide when I'm getting you close. When we move, well, you already know. So just imagine. Nothing I can see but you when you dance, dance, dance. Feel a good, good creeping up on you. So just dance, dance, dance. Come on. All those things I shouldn't do, but you dance. So keep dancing. I can't stop the feeling. So just dance, dance, dance. I can't stop the feeling. So just dance, dance, dance. Come on. Ooh, it's something magical. It's in the air, it's in my blood, it's rushing on. I don't need no reason, don't be control. I fly so high, no ceiling when I'm in my zone. Cause I got that sunshine in my pocket. Got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it. Moving so phenomenally. You're more like the way we rock it. So don't stop, stop, stop. Under the lights when everything goes. Nowhere to hide when I'm getting you close. When we move, well, you already know. So just imagine. Nothing I can see but you when you dance, dance, dance. Feel the good, good creeping up on you. So just dance, dance, dance. Come on. All those things I shouldn't do, but you dance, dance, dance. And ain't nobody leaving soon, so keep dancing. I can't stop the feeling. So just dance.